That G minor riff you just heard me play is using one of the coolest sounding minor harmonies out there. Thousands of bands and songs use this sound, and today I'm going to teach it to you. We'll start by learning a unique version of the open position G minor chord. Then I'm going to work through a special way to play an F major that uses the thumb in the bass. Plus, I'm going to add a couple of seventh quality chords into the mix just to give things that Jimmy Page, Led Zeppelin effect. Now, before we get started learning about all this stuff, I have a quick word that I want to share with you first about my Handouts Collection ebook offer. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. This lesson introduces a unique chord pattern for playing an open position G minor chord. Now, in our examples, this chord will function as the foundation across a chord progression in G minor, and this progression will also incorporate a few other chord options from the same harmony that'll all work together to provide a very cool sound. So let's get things started by learning the chord shapes first. The initial chord shape here is going to look just like that. Now, this is a kind of a rare chord for a lot of people. It's not very common, and what it is a G minor in the open position. We've got our low G note down there on the sixth string's third fret, open fourth string, and then a B flat and a D up on the third fret areas of both third string and second string. Now I'm playing this with some finger picking, just basic, you know, finger picking style, kind of like classical guitar orientation, but you could use a pick if you'd like to and just strum across it, but I'm just going to use finger style today. Let's move on to the next chord. It's going to be an F major, but a little bit of a twist on the F major. You can see what I'm doing is I'm hooking my thumb over the top of the neck to grab that low first fret sixth string F note, and then with the other fingers, ring, middle, and index, I'm playing the F, A, and C notes across fourth, third, and second strings. So it's a little bit different, and it's something that takes a little bit of practice. You know, for a lot of people, it's going to work out okay. I do have to mention that there are some people, a very low percentage of people, who cannot do this. It's just, you know, however their thumb knuckle is, it just doesn't hook over and bend, you know, the way that's, you know, let's say 80% of everyone else's thumb knuckle does. So if you cannot do it, you just might be one of that small, you know, 10 or 20% of folks that just can't do that particular hooked over thumb technique. You know, no sense to be discouraged about it. Hey, there's other ways to do it. You could just flatten your finger out, do a full on bar. That'll work fine. But it is cool if you can do the thumb in the bass technique. So anyway, that's our F chord with the thumb in the bass. The next idea that we're going to move on to is actually the next two ideas are going to be seventh quality chords. This first one is an E flat major 7. Overall, it's not too bad of a chord to learn. We've got our index finger down there on the E flat note on the fourth string first fret, and ring finger is laying flat across the top three strings at the third fret to generate the remainder of the notes for the E flat major 7 chord. So for some people, barring might be kind of a challenge, but with some work, you know, you could even pull that chord along the neck to try to get a little bit better at your barring technique. But overall, I do not think it will take you very long to get that one down. The last chord is going to be our turnaround chord. It is a dominant seventh chord, and it's off the D. So what we're really doing is creating a dominant seventh, 5 chord in G minor, and it's a really nice sound. It's got a little bit different accent to it, but it's quite cool, you know. I like the sound of it. It's really got an interesting essence to pull us back around to our G minor root chord once again. Now, talking about, you know, we're starting to get into talking about moving these chords from one to the next. Let me just show you a chord progression that you can start practicing. It's just the cycle of these exact chords going in order from G minor into the F major, and then the E flat major 7, and then the D dominant 7. So what you're going to want to do is just practice these in a loop at first and just get as good as you possibly can at them. And you could strum them or you could, you know, pluck them like I'm doing here. It's up to you. But get them going on in a cycle so that you get your fret hand technique to really get the grips down and everything feels fairly comfortable. And then I have one final exercise I want to show you. This one's going to be adding some embellishments from the G minor scale in and around these chords. And it sounds really nice. Here's what it goes on like. Check it out. That sound is probably one of my favorite approaches. That's kind of like why I was going finger style on this thing today, because I wanted to be able to bring out the filler tones and some of those passing notes that can occur in and around the chord changes that we have. And I just think it's a great sound to do, especially if you want to maybe just play solo guitar, just have maybe an acoustic, and you know, or just maybe you're at the cabin and you just want to sit on the porch and just kind of play some lines and so forth. It works great. Those articulations and embellishments are just notes of the scale, the G minor scale, and I'm just tossing them in after every chord hit there. So the chart for that, if you want to learn it all in detail and get all the extra information for this lesson plan, it's all available over on my Patreon. All you got to do is go to patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio, and any tier level over there, whether it's $3, $5, $15, you get access to these releases. I call these my Friday Patreon Plus releases. They come out on Fridays, and it's just a fun lesson. As you can tell, this is a really nice sound and a really nice exercise to work through, but a lot of professionals use this. You know, like, it's something that occurs in just hundreds and hundreds of songs, probably thousands of songs. So it's a great technique to understand. It's a great flow of chord changes to understand as well, because it is extremely popular. So anyway, guys, I'm going to wrap up the lesson. Thanks for joining me. Want to mention one more thing. If you want to get your chops up to a whole other level playing guitar, maybe you want to just like study a really thorough, well broken down course, you know, that's real chapter by chapter and step by step in its orientation, go and check out my website. It's a different website than Patreon. It's creativeguitarstudio.com. It's the website that I have where all of my guitar lessons are, and you can join for just as little as $19.95 a month, and you'll get access to everything except the core curriculum downloads. What that means is the core curriculum courses, which are my beginners, intermediate, and advanced. If you want to get in-depth study on those ones, it's better to buy the premium membership. A full year of lessons, which also gives you full access to everything on that website, is only $179.40. And you got access for 12 months, and you can download all of the stuff on the site. So go check it out. It's at creativeguitarstudio.com. And for the handout of this lesson, plus access to all my Patreon material, and I've been doing Patreon for like 4 years, there's hundreds and hundreds of lessons on there, just head over to patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. Learning chord riffs like this will help get you one step closer to becoming the best guitar player that you can be. To learn more, sign up for a free membership today at creativeguitarstudio.com. With a free membership, you'll be able to access all the free lesson material, including a collection of 6 years of YouTube archives, where there are hundreds of videos, PDF handouts, and MP3 jam tracks. Plus, with a free membership, you'll gain access to the Quick Licks program, a 30-lesson course covering guitar licks in all playing styles across all types of scales and arpeggios. When you sign up for a paid membership, you'll get access to my core curriculum, including my beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs. Plus, there's also my elective courses on the site, like acoustic guitar, guitar technique, guitar soloing, ear training, music reading, and many others. Go check it out. You're going to love it. The website is creativeguitarstudio.com. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.